So today our topic of discussion is genetic code. Now genetic code is what? It's the relationship between the sequence of nucleotides on mRNA and the sequence of amino acid in the polypeptide. So you have to first understand what is transcription, that already we have discussed in the previous class, but try to understand that this is a DNA strand. Okay, so it is a DNA strand. It is 3 prime to 5 prime and this is a polarity. Now this DNA strand, this is the template strand. Okay, now this one is the template strand from where mRNA is formed. This mRNA is formed having the polarity like this, and by the process of transcription. But now the question is that next process is translation, and translation is, in the translation process, how the amino acids are going to arrange. So whatever the sequence of DNA strand, template strand, the complementary bases will come here. Okay, the complementary bases have some sequence. So in this genetic code, whatever the sequence that the mRNA has, that sequence is coded by the amino acid. So whatever the codons, the codon triplets, triplet codons are read by the enzymes, and like that the amino acids are going to come, and these amino acids are joined by peptide bond. So these are 20 types of amino acids. These 20 types of amino acid can come in any sequence, means can anything, any arrangement, as the sequence there is in the mRNA. So here these amino acids are joined by peptide bond, and ultimately the polypeptide molecule is formed. So this is called polypeptide molecule is formed. So this we are going to read. Like now the genetic code suggests us that whatever the sequence in this mRNA, and that sequence codes what amino acids. So it is the sequence of nucleotides on mRNA and the sequence of amino acid in the polypeptide molecule. So that relationship is described by this genetic code. Now this genetic code will tell us the actual thing, that what amino acids are going to come. So let's see who discovered this genetic code. It is the George Gamow is the scientist. And then Hargobind Khurana, Marshall Nirenberg. Hargobind Khurana and Severo Ochoa. So these scientists actually gave the idea of genetic code. So let's see what is the contribution of George Gamow. He is actually a physicist. Proposed that in order to code for all the 20 amino acids, the code should be made up of 3 nucleotides, triplet code. Okay. Now he only gave the idea that 64 codons, and then 4 into 4 into 4. So in that way the amino acids are coded by triplet codons. So 3 bases constitute 1 codon. Hargobind Khurana developed a chemical method for the synthesis of RNA molecule, and who also defined the base combinations. And Marshall Nirenberg, cell-free system for protein synthesis, helped in deciphering the code. And Severo Ochoa showed that the polynucleotide phosphorylase helped in polymerization of RNA with defined sequence in template independent manner. So on this basis of the above discoveries by these 4 scientists, they constitute a genetic code, and this genetic code diagram is given in NCERT. So where the blocks are there, right, then 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks are there. So here U, C, A, G, here also U, C, A, G, 4 blocks are there, U, C, A, G. But then each block is again U, C, A, G, U, C, A, G, like that it is divided. And you can see how to meet U, U, U. So the first block, the first one is U, U, first codon. U, U, C, U, U, C. Like this it will continue. So in this way genetic code is made by them. So this is the first position, second position, and third position. Third position, bases, nitrogenous bases. And you can see now this UUU is coding phenyl PHT written, that means phenylalanine. UUC is also coding phenylalanine. UUA is coding leucine and UUG is leucine. So these leucine, phenylalanine, serine, tryptophan, then cysteine, proline, histidine, glutamine, arginine, isoleucine, valine, alanine, ascorbic acid, okay, glutamic acid, glycine, lysine, arginine, methionine. So these are all amino acids. If you reveal the genetic code, you will get which triplet codon codes which amino acid. And as per that, these triplet codons are the sequence of MR. Okay, so this is the genetic code. What are the features of genetic code from this? That means there are total 64 codons, but out of that 61 codes, but 3 does not code. 3 codons, these codons are called as stop codons. And this, that initiation codon is AUG, whereas stop codons are UAA, UGA and UAG. So they do not code for any amino acid that actually stop the translation process, but this is the initiation codon AUG. And now this one codon codes for one amino acid, and that's why it is called as unambiguous. And when many codons codes for one amino acid, and we say this is degenerate. And because of this degeneracy, the mutations are hidden. They cannot express. So degeneration of genetic code is a very important thing to maintain the species stability. Genetic code is universal. That means from bacteria to human being, this is followed. Universal. Genetic code is universal. From bacteria to human being, this is called. And AUG is having dual function. It codes for the amino acid methionine as well as it acts as an insulin. Okay. So, now, as we have seen that mRNA has coded the message that is given on DNA. Now, what is the role of tRNA? So, tRNA is a transfer RNA which is called as adapter molecule. The presence of an adapter molecule which could read the code and would bind to specific amino acid during translation was proposed by Francis Crick in 1961. Okay? So, tRNA was known before genetic code and was called sRNA, that is soluble RNA. But later it is called as adapter molecule. The adapter molecule is what? That means this tRNA is having actually a very special structure. This is called clover leaf model. And this tRNA has got three loops. This is the 5' and 3'. And you can see in 3', at the 3' end, there is an amino acid attachment. And a D loop, anticodon loop, variable arm, and T loops are there. Now this anticodon loop is very, very important. It has got the complementary base sequence, whatever they are on mRNA, okay. And this is the anticodon, that is the opposite of codon. Now triplet codons are present on mRNA, so the opposite complementary of that codon, that is anticodon bases are there. An amino acid acceptor end is there, T loop is there, D loop is there, and variable R is there. So this tRNA, how does it act? You know, this is the mRNA, okay. Now already you know this is the mRNA. Now thus mRNA has got, suppose the first initiation codon is AUG. So I have written only one codon, try to understand. This is AUG. Now which transfer RNA will come here? You know, the transfer RNA which has got the amino acid, that is methionine. And methionine has got the anticodon here. What? A opposite is U. U opposite is A and then C. So this is actually the role of tRNA. The tRNA brings the amino acid which that tRNA is carrying, and it has got the anticodon UAC, And remember, this transfer RNA will come whenever there is AUG, because this is the complementary sequence that the tRNA has, and it comes from translation process. So in this way, when the mRNA sequence is there in the endoplasmic reticulum, then ribosome is going to form at this place. So first there is a smaller unit of ribosome, and then a bigger unit of ribosome will come, and then this gives a quite a good site for protein synthesis. And this tRNA, one by one carrying the amino acid as per the sequence, they will come, and their, you know, detection recognition is by this anticodon loop will go on. So this is the process that translation will happen in this. So translation process is what, by which the triplet base sequence on mRNA guides the linking of a specific sequence of amino acid to form a polypeptide on ribosome is called translation. And the machinery requires what? Ribosome, mRNA, tRNA synthetase enzyme that helps in combining the amino acid, then peptidyl transferase. So all these enzymes are needed for this translation process. Now translation process, the first that is a things happen that is the activation of amino acid. This amino acid is attached to this 3' end, and that is amino acid plus ATP. ATP spent for this process, magnesium is required, amino acid, tRNA synthetase is required. These enzymes help to form AMP enzyme complex. Okay, amino acid, adenosine monophosphate enzyme complex. So, and then after that, this ribosomes join, 30S and 50S subunits of ribosome join. Then initiation happens. Initiation, already I said the initiator codon is AUG. So AUG is the initiator codon. The first transfer RNA is coming along with the methionine amino acid. Then elongation of this polypeptide chain happens, like whatever the sequence is there after AUG. Suppose GGG. That means which transfer RNA will come whose anticodon loop carry CCC. So that amino acid glycine or serine will come. And then this elongation will go on as long as. So that means how it is going on? Like it is the GGG. Right. Suppose now UAA will come, and you know that UAA is the stop codon. So that stop codon stop the translation, because nothing will, no amino acid is going to come, and that is the termination site. And the release factor is there, which also terminates the polypeptide molecule. And peptidyl transferase enzyme is there, which helps in formation of the peptide molecules over here. So the polypeptide molecule will come out after the translation process. So, and that polypeptide molecule can be the enzyme, can be the hormone, can be any required protein of the cell. So this is the translation. So go through NCRT and ask your doubts in tomorrow's online class. Thank you.